And good evening, ladies and gentlemen in attendance here at ringside. And at this time, a very warm welcome to you, the viewers, joining us at home. We're live on Channel 5 from the Ice Arena in Cardiff, Wales. Blaine McGuigan for Cyclone Promotions in association with Golden Boy Promotions and Sanigar Events, sponsored by Maxi Nutrition, Ladbrokes, and Volterol for the joy of movement. Are very proud to bring you 12 rounds of boxing for the IBF Bantamweight Championship of the World. All our officials at ringside, appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control and the International Boxing Federation, joining me in the ring from the board, the chairman, John Rees QC, from the IBF, our supervisor, from New Jersey, USA, Mr. Eddie Cotton. Our three scoring judges, from Toronto, Canada, Mr. Alan Davis, from Doncaster, England, Mr. Howard Foster, from Orlando, Florida, USA, Mr. Alex Levin. On the bell, our timekeeper is Dave Waters, and when the bell rings, referee in charge, from Preston, England, Mr. Phil Edwards. And so, ladies and gentlemen in attendance here at ringside, and for those watching live on Channel 5, the officials are ready, the boxers are ready, are you ready for the main event? Introducing the challenger. He's boxing out of the red corner. He's winning black with silver trim. At the weigh-in, he's scaled 8 stone, 5 pounds, 117 pounds. From 30 contests, 29 wins, 17 wins inside the distance, only one defeat. The reigning WBC International Silver Champion. Tonight, he is the challenger. Los Caballeros de Tijuana, Mexico, Ivan Morales. And across the ring stands the champion, boxing out of the blue corner, winning blue with silver trim. On the scales, 8 stone, 5 pounds, 3 ounces, 117 and 1 quarter pounds. From 35 contests, 32 wins, 14 wins inside the distance, only 3 defeats. He is the former English champion, 2-weight British champion, 2-weight Commonwealth champion, former European champion. Tonight, making the first defense of his world crown, the reigning IBF Bantamweight Champion of the World, from Bristol, Avon, England, Lee Playboy Haskins.
Well, having lost to Edgar Jimenez, just outworked against him, he's come back with a win, but this is a step up for Ivan Morales and for Lee Haskins. It is a chance to prove that he deserves to be world champion. Defends his title here tonight, but wants in his mind to win it in the ring. And one thing is for sure, Ivan Morales will never have fought anybody with the style of Lee Haskins, because there is no one with a style like Lee Haskins.
I read a great quote from Haskins before this contest, and he was saying that his opponents often say that they've worked him out and they know what they're going to do against him, and he says that's impossible, he said, because he doesn't know what he's going to do when he gets in there. He's a boxer that just reacts, boxes on instinct, throws punches from all different angles, very elusive, very difficult to get to, and he punches very hard, Dave.
When he's had problems, and he has had problems, it's when his unorthodoxy becomes predictable. Saw that against Stefan Jamwa. Found out as well by Chifua Munyai and Ian Napa as well, but he is on quite a streak, Haskins, and he started powerfully here. Morales trying to win the battle of the jabs there. You never know what Haskins is going to lead with.
In his last contest against the Japanese boxer, Masaki Iwasa, he was another tall, was perfect preparation for this one, to be quite honest, because he was a tall southpaw also. And he sorted him out. He started very quickly, did Lee Haskins. Morales here, he's just waiting, isn't he, a little bit. I think the pace is probably suiting Haskins at this stage. He prefers that leisurely pace, sees the opponents coming, and then he responds with those fast counters. So it's going okay for the moment anyway for Lee Haskins.
Break. A little bit scrappy there. When he fought Edgar Jimenez, who goes by the nickname of Power, which gives you the idea of what kind of fighter he is, real bull of a man. Morales tried to box him on the back foot, and Jimenez got to him, but he started with similar tactics here. A little chopping right there from Haskins. It was a good sneaky shot.
He's got to vary his power a little bit, Haskins. I don't want him putting everything into every shot. It's going to take it out of him a little bit. Remember, he's in a 12-round contest here, Morales. Mexican, they're all tough from over there. And keeping that guard nice and high. So a lot of these shots are hitting the gloves. He's looking for a clean shot here. If it lands, then, yeah, it may have an effect. But at the moment, then, Haskins not hitting the target as such. That was a good body shot then.
Don't let him mislead you.
Well, Lee Haskins surely took that opening round. But Ivan Morales, as Richie's mentioned, will stick around unless he's encouraged to do otherwise. And that would be the worry, I think, for those who feel Haskins potentially could be beaten. It's that he'd be outlasted by this fella. Just a feeling that Haskins can work too hard in the early part of fights, and that he was blowing a bit against Iwasa, and he took him out with that wonderful shot, the shot of a lifetime. But Haskins looks relaxed, and he started well here. A couple of good shots as well, Richie.
He started very positively, won that first round, and he's putting some good work together here, but it is a 12-round contest, like we've said, so he's got to hit the target more cleanly for me, as Haskins. But he's in control at the moment. But what you said, Dave, if it does go over 7 or 8 rounds, it's those later, in the later stages, those championship rounds, gets caught there with a nice shot. He'll keep those hands up a little bit higher as his opponent's coming towards him.
Yeah, he walked on to a left hand there that he should have seen coming a mile away. Little moment of success for Ivan Morales. Haskins, though, on the front foot, trying to take control of this fight. Right to the body from Haskins. He's missing a lot, though, Haskins, in these early stages.
The pace is actually suiting him, Dave. He slowed it down. And Morales is playing a waiting game, just the odd shot coming here and there. But Haskins, for me, like I said, he prefers this type of pace. Very good at slowing things down, is Haskins. That's because he likes to see the opponents coming, and he can react with those counters. But when his opponent comes through there, he's just got to keep his hands a little bit higher, as Haskins getting caught with shots that he shouldn't really be.
Ivan Morales has won 29 of his 30 fights at the age of 24. 17 knockouts. He does have power. If Haskins should walk in with his chin up in the air. Certainly a feeling around boxing, though, that when Lee Haskins was crowned world champion, one of the nice guys had done it. Really popular. A little warning there from Phil Edwards, holding and hitting there. Nothing serious, but just a word in his ear.
A bit closer this round, Dave, but I still think that Haskins has done enough just to nick the round. Fairly good start again from Haskins.
There's the Ivan Morales corner. Diego Morales is in there. There's that shot, Richie.
Yeah, that was a nice shot from Morales. Good clean shot that he landed there. I just thought that Haskins did enough to win the round. I got him two rounds up, but it was a closer round.
Yeah, Erik Morales not here. Diego Morales, who did also briefly hold a world title, is in the corner with Carlos Duarte and Alberto Lopez. Can they encourage their man and school him sufficiently to cause the upset here and rip away Lee Haskins' world title that he's waited so long for?
What's important here, Dave, is for Haskins, when Morales is coming forward, he's got to adjust his feet and go backwards and try and bring him onto a counter, because if he doesn't, if he holds his feet, he's got such a low lead hand, then he's just going to walk onto another left hand for Morales. So he's got to adjust his feet, step back, bring him onto the shot as Morales comes forward. Very important. That's better. There you go.
Morales with those hands held high keeps coming forward, but Haskins caught him again there. Danger of being a little bit messy and scrappy. Haskins just biding his time and trying to pick his shots here. The right hand, Morales moved backwards there.
I think Morales is realizing he's got to get closer to Haskins. He's starting to come forward a lot more now on that front foot than he was in the opening couple of rounds. And if he comes forward with slow feet, that will suit Haskins. Haskins can bring him onto the shot as long as he adjusts, like I said.
And in this third round, Morales has really started to unload, significantly so. Interesting clash of styles, this often is with Lee Haskins, and that's good work from him.
It's important that Morales keeps that guard high as he's coming forward. He's got a fairly slow jab, and that's allowing Haskins to come back with that left hand counter. His feet are too slow at this stage, Morales. He's got to quicken things up if he's going to get to Lee Haskins, and may have to double up the attack rather than just that single attack. I think Haskins there just signaled to the ref, a bit of a clash of heads there.
Morales can look a little square as well. Those feet are a bit slow, and in that fight against Edgar Jimenez, you saw him almost walking onto shots. So far, so good, but nothing definitive yet for Lee Haskins.
Beautiful. Come on.
So there's the Lee Haskins corner. Well. Hearing the words of Chris Saniger. Known Lee since he was 14 years of age. So proud, so happy when Haskins beat Iwasa, and then after that interim title was crowned world champion. But he wants now to keep it going. Haskins in the blue shorts against Ivan Morales, the Mexican, the younger brother of the great, and I mean great, Erik Morales.
Although it was the first Mexican to win four different weights. Four world titles at different weights, wasn't he? What a legend.
Morales then just looking at Phil Edwards and suggesting Haskins was using the elbow.
I think Haskins is dealing with the single attacks with no real problems. That was a nice shot, that was a nice move there from Haskins. Just leads with the hook, but then comes back with that left hand, that was good. I think Morales has got to double up the attacks or maybe double up the jab. Put a little bit more sustained pressure on Haskins. He's going to get to him, he's got to go again, that's when he's got to go. See how he stopped after that single attack. That just allows that Haskins just to step back and assess the situation, regroup. So the pace is suiting him.
Haskins landed there, but so too did Morales with a left hook.
Morales is learning as he's going along, he's got to get closer. Got to quicken those feet up. Bit of swelling below the right eye of Morales now. Testament of that, those left hands that Haskins has been landing.
A little slow again with that southpaw jab, Morales. Left uppercut from Haskins as again, Morales just can't get his shots away. You hear those Bristolian voices in this Cardiff crowd trying to encourage their man. From Morales, and just caught Haskins. Single shot there from Morales.
I don't know what Haskins was doing there. He just showboating a little bit there and got caught. Hands very, very low. Playing with fire there, moving that head so close.
When you move, you're the best as well. Chop it, big point.
All right. Well, he just gets caught with a shot here, doesn't he, Lee Haskins? Oh, this is actually stuff from earlier on in the round. Just moving his head in and out, then gets caught there on the way out with that shot. Good shot from Morales, but he didn't do enough to win the round for me.
Well, Lee Haskins has completed 12 rounds on six occasions. Morales never. That might come into play here. Although Haskins will hope not, he will hope to catch Morales and get this done quicker than that.
See, that's the problem there. So Morales now just quickening those feet up. Once he does that and then throws that left hand, he's going to catch Haskins. Haskins, the way he's moving, he's got to keep that right hand a little bit higher. That's a little bit better. You've got to get that guard up, else you're going to walk onto those left hands. Morales is sussing it out now. He's thinking, I've got to get closer to him. I've got to quicken the feet up. That's what he's trying to do now, Morales.
The opportunity missing badly there with it, left hook.
Yeah, and Dave, the opportunity may come for Haskins now to land a solid shot as Morales is getting more confident to come over that front foot.
Yeah, Morales growing in confidence, but with that confidence comes danger. Fight starting to warm up, though, in this fifth round. Little warning here from Phil Edwards just to encourage them not to hold, not to turn, not to spin, to make it a spectacle. Haskins unloaded there with that left, but Morales blocked it fairly comfortably.
Morales has kept a fairly high guard throughout, hasn't he? Blocked a lot of the shots. I think it's been a good start these first few rounds for Haskins. But he's just showing signs, Dave, of slowing down a little bit. Maybe just taking his foot off the gas slightly. A lot of single shots coming from Haskins. A little bit better. And the pace is suiting him. But again, there are signs that Morales is starting to think a little bit more of getting up close, moving those feet into position. It's not a bad left hand there for Morales.
Yeah, just little encouraging moments for Morales, who must be behind on all three scorecards. It's hard to make a case for him winning a round so far. But as the younger man by 8 years, he'll always have felt that if he could take this late, he would give himself a chance.
Just heard the Haskins corner saying, get your feet moving. And you know, when he's moving those feet, he's causing more problems, he's more elusive for Morales. And can't just tag him and nail him down.
Nice, all right, use your experience, but mobile.
Well, there's
mobile.
Richie's what? Scorecard so far. You've got Lee Haskins winning every round.
I think he's taken every round, yeah. Some of the rounds have been a little bit closer, but he's done enough to win them for me.
So Lee Haskins in the blue shorts here, the man from Bristol, defending his IBF bantamweight title against Ivan Morales, most famous thus far for being the younger brother of the great Erik, wanting to become respected and famous in his own right. Every time Haskins gets close, Morales is holding. Yet really to land a solid, spiteful shot.
Slight change in tactics here from Morales. He's opting to go on the back foot, maybe to draw Haskins in a little bit. It's been Haskins on the back foot for most of this contest up to now. That style certainly suits him. Good head movement there, needed to come back with something. But Morales, his corner may have said, right, you've got to bring him on to you. They know he's behind.
You can see that's frustrating Haskins already a couple of times. He's gestured for Morales to say, come on. Doesn't like Morales sitting back. Left there was a stiff shot from Morales. Haskins landed as well as he came in.
Yeah, both landing shots there. A worrying sign there for Haskins. He got caught just on the way out, but a good reply again from Haskins, putting his man under pressure.
Well, that was better from Haskins. Can he sustain the pressure, though? Can he take Morales somewhere he doesn't want to go? Mandatory for this title is Stewie Hall, a man who Haskins has already beaten, trying to set up an all-British world title fight. Good work there from Haskins as we approach the final minute of this sixth round, and Morales is starting to take a risk or two.
I think he knows he's behind, Dave, so yeah, he is taking a risk coming forward occasionally. Terrible miss there from Haskins, but again, he slowed the pace down, he's controlling the pace for me. Morales is not doing enough to win these rounds. A lovely right up to the body there from Haskins. That was a terrific shot.
Haskins again missed with a big left hook, looking for that finishing punch that hasn't been there.
Just skinned off the target, left hand, but again, Haskins round.
There is the Ivan Morales corner, led by Carlos Enrique Duarte, Diego Morales and Alberto Lopez, so one big brother in there, trying to encourage him. A little change of tactics in the previous round. Will Morales stay on the back foot and look to catch Haskins as he comes in?
Well, he had a bit of success with it. He caught Haskins as Haskins was moving away a couple of times. So he was obviously trying to draw Lee Haskins in, but I just don't think he's doing enough to win these rounds for me, Morales. He's on away soil, remember. He's going to be taking these rounds. He's not doing it. He's not doing enough work. He's waiting far too long. And his feet are just a little bit too slow, Dave. He's going to sustain a little bit more pressure and put Haskins, for me, under a bit more pressure. I think Haskins has controlled the pace really well. And it's not a blistering pace, but it's a pace that is suiting him.
Well, given that beforehand, many felt the danger for Haskins was that Iván Morales might outwork him. Given that Haskins has just thrown the best punch of the fight and caught Morales, he hasn't applied any kind of game plan here. He certainly hasn't outworked Haskins, and he felt that shot. Tries to respond with a left hand of his own.
Yeah, Haskins just allowed him 15, 20 seconds to recover from that left hand. That was the best left hand that he'd thrown, Lee Haskins. It was a good shot. But Morales, you could tell, he felt it the way he went back. Nothing came back for him for a good 15, 20 seconds. Then he comes back with his own straight left. And boxers at this level, after 10 or 15 seconds from a shot like that, they're recovered, they're that fit. But it was a good shot from Lee Haskins.
One accusation about Haskins over the years was always that he was guilty sometimes of admiring his work, and I think that's what he did there. He caught him with a great shot, didn't follow it up.
Haskins himself taking risks, though, Dave, coming forward there with very low hands. Both missed the target there, but both really went for it.
Been able really to judge the distance between the other just yet. Both miss, both have felt like they've thrown shots from the wrong kind of range.
This could come down, Dave, to some lapse in concentration. I think Haskins is well ahead here. The longer this contest goes on, his concentration levels start to dip a little bit, and that's when you can walk onto a big shot. Got to keep alert. He's doing well up to now. We're still five or six rounds away from the end.
Yeah, five to go after this.
Wasn't
there? So there's Chris Sanniger in there with Nigel Christian and Dave Moxon. You can have a listen to him.
Your brain. Little squirt down there as well. Open your mouth.
Come to you when you're ready.
Okay.
Easy.
Let's take a look at some of the work from that round.
Yeah, good shot there from Morales, but there's that left hand. It actually hit the glove, didn't it? Looked from our position that it landed, but it didn't. Then they went for it. This was where they both stepped in. But Haskins just allowed Morales just to step off and recover.
So Lee Haskins surely well ahead. This round eight, the first defence of his IBF bantamweight title, and a chance to have the feeling of being a world champion in the ring. That was a tangle of legs, by the way.
Lovely shot there from Haskins, throwing that jab from the hip. Very hard to detect when the jab thrown from there. Not recommended for everyone to do it. Obviously, the hands are very low, but occasionally just catches your opponent as it did there. Good punch.
And look at his corner there from Morales. Little flurries of action here.
Morales starting to step on the gas a little bit. Should have been doing this a lot earlier, Dave. I'm surprised his corner. Having said, step in. Double that jab up. Get to your man. commit a little bit more, put him under a little bit more pressure.
Right jab to the body there from Ivan Morales, but he hasn't done enough. If the saying goes, the challenger has to come and rip the title from the champion. He's come nowhere near that. He's expecting all energy, a little bit wild, but we haven't seen that at all.
He hasn't sustained any pressure, has he, in any attacks? The odd single shot's gone in, long straight left hand, yes. Yeah, look there, nice right hook, but he just tends to just take a step back rather than go forward and put pressure on.
Well, he looked such a confident man in the dressing room. Carl Frampton spoke about it, relaxed, but he hasn't looked confident in the ring, Ivan Morales.
He watched the contest when he fought Jimenez, lost on a split decision there, a majority decision, and he concedes his height and reach a lot. Well, he did in that contest. I thought that would suit Haskins. He stood a little bit taller here, but the pace was a lot more in the Jimenez fight. It was a lot faster. Maybe we have to give Haskins credit for slowing things down, because the pace has suited Haskins down to the ground, and Morales and his corner, they haven't really sussed that out. And at one point, I thought he was going to step on the gas and really go for Haskins and put him under a little bit more, but it's back to the same as.
Haskins with a huge swing there. One landed after the bell from Morales. Haskins dominant. Surely on the way to retaining his title, but still plenty of time to go. We can hear now from Carl Frampton to get his views with Mark Pugac.
Thanks, Dave. Yes. Carl, what do you think? He's comfortably ahead, isn't he, Lee?
I think he is comfortably ahead. I think Arapusha would give Morales one round. Maybe even just give it level, but Lee's doing well here. Morales is starting that round. There were signs of him becoming a little bit more ragged. I think Lee can take advantage of that, but he's looking good and comfortably in lead.
So as far as he's concerned, just carry on like this for the next few rounds, and he should be home and
just
dry.
Continue to do what he's doing. I think that if he continues to do that, the more ragged that Morales becomes, I think he could catch him and possibly stop him late.
Carl, thank you. Speak to you later.
Thanks very much indeed, Mark. Ivan Morales said beforehand, I want the name of our family to be immortal. Three brothers to be world champions. Well, he needs to produce something very, very special to make that happen. He needs a stoppage now, Richie.
I think so. I think the corner have told him that. I think the corner have said, the way he's come out in this round, it's all or nothing now, you just got to go for it. You're well behind, put him under a little bit, and that's what he's doing. There's more action in the first 30 seconds of this round. There has been in a lot of the rounds for Morales, so he's coming forward, taking the odd risk, yes, because Haskins likes boxers to come forward, but he's losing, so he's got to do something different here. Hey, Morales, he's got to go for it.
Three rounds to go after this. Can Morales find that special something that he needs now? Or will it be Haskins' night in Cardiff, on his way to that all-British world title fight against Stewie Hall? Looking that way, but Morales, given that little bit of power he has, must still have an outside chance.
Looking
slimmer by the second, though.
Yeah, most definitely, Dave. You just got to, you know, Haskins has got to keep concentrating. We're four rounds away from winning this contest. And look at Morales now. I think he senses it now. He's behind, going forward. It's a better round for Morales. So it's all about concentration now. Haskins should be fit enough. But at this level, you take your eye off the ball, and it could all be over one shot.
The level at which Lee Haskins has always wanted to operate, and finally is operating. Bill Edwards having a word with them. Desperately trying to make this a more watchable spectacle. Haskins, though, doing enough.
Here again. It's a case of one box his feet far too slow. Morales coming forward. Haskins can see these attacks coming. Just adjusts his feet. And being a counter puncher the way he is, it's perfect for him at the moment.
Let's try and take a listen now to Chris Saniger again in that Lee right. Haskins corner.
Just need to be busy with that jab now, you know what I mean? All right?
Yeah. You've got to go to your left a little more, okay?
And they look like they're...
looking awesome, buddy. Awesome. Awesome.
In control.
Keep moving. Keep right, the jab.
You know, Lee Haskins will want to keep entertain. There's Richie's scorecard, just that one shared round, the eighth, but Haskins in total command.
Right, yeah.
He'll want to entertain, but he also wants to hold on to his world title. It's the tightrope that he's walking.
You've got to hold on to the title at all costs, especially his age.
Three rounds to go. Haskins coming out and throwing just about his best combination of the fight there. Morales looking for that left hand all the time.
Nice fast start for Haskins in this round. I think that spurred Morales on as well, remember? Barry McGuigan described his family as Mexican royalty in terms of boxing. Remember the boxing royalty, Mexican boxing royalty, that's what Bantamweight said. Super shot from Haskins.
A lovely clean shot from Haskins as Morales took a risk, and Morales felt that and he walked onto another one. Throws punches from such unusual angles, Haskins.
Well, that was a great shot because he seemed to change direction and threw the shot. Very good indeed. Moving to his left and then just very quickly moves to his right and throws that left hand, brings his opponent onto it.
And they look worried in that Morales corner. A little glance over to them. Wonder if their man has the answers here.
This is where it could go either way, though, no, Dave. They're both trying to land big shots, and with Lee Haskins with those hands so low, he's got to watch what he's doing.
He trusts his instincts, he always has done, trusts his reactions. Right to the body from Haskins, and they can be punishing shots late on in a fight. Using his feet well now, Haskins really warming to the task. Looks like he's got plenty in the tank as well.
Yeah, clever movements from Haskins. Just going to watch that low lead hand of his as Morales is coming forward. He's looking to land that left hand, you see. And Haskins cleverly just trying him up on the inside and gets back to range.
It has never really caught fire.
No, it's another classic, but the important thing is for Lee Haskins is to win, get over the line, and bigger fights are to follow. But this one's not over yet.
I wonder if Haskins can turn on the style now as we approach the final couple of rounds. two rounds to go. Haskins started the round with that great bit of work, and Morales certainly felt those shots, and he looks frustrated in that corner.
Yeah, it was a fast start to the round from Lee Haskins. Lovely 1-2 combination. Fast out of the blocks there. Lovely left hand, that's the best shot of the round for Haskins. Brought his opponent onto it as he led to his right. And another round for him.
Absolutely. Final bit of advice, but it could be an awkward hurdle, but looks like he's getting over it okay. Haskins just looking at the bit of water that was down in that corner, asking for it to be mopped. He looked bothered by it the minute he came out, and he has slipped a couple of times. Finally, we can get back underway. Well-timed shot again there from Haskins.
Boxing well again on the back foot, Lee Haskins. Starting to bring his opponent again onto that left hand. Morales knows he's behind. Yeah, the referee there, I think he's had enough of Haskins holding on the inside. So he's just got to be careful these next 6 minutes or so. He doesn't want, there's a warning. I think he's well ahead though, Dave. He really is. But he's clearly probably feeling a little bit, he's getting a little bit more tired. That's why he's holding on the inside, just to get a little bit of a breather.
Yeah, it doesn't feel like a point deduction would be the end of the world, but he'd still rather not have that reputation. Remember, this was someone who used to be criticised for being in dull fights. He's lost that reputation, but he doesn't want it back. Held again there, you know. Will Edwards had another look at it. To go in the penultimate round. The uppercut there from Haskins. Now Morales is coming forward, is trying to hunt Lee Haskins down, but he's hard to fight.
Well, that's part of the game plan you see from Haskins there. The movement is very good indeed, and he's just inviting his opponent to come forward, because then he comes back with very fast counters. You've got to be fit to do this type of work, but it's good at the moment from Haskins. That's all he's doing there, on the outside, keeping that movement going, inviting his opponent to come forward to try and get desperate and bring him onto a shot.
Oh, can he finish with a powerful flourish here?
There are big fights down the road, aren't there? From a British perspective, Stewie Hall is the mandatory for Haskins if he gets through this. There's Jamie McDonald also, WBA champ. So exciting times ahead for Lee Haskins if he can win this contest.
Morales for a moment thought he had him in the corner, but Haskins used his good footwork to get out of there. It just feels like Haskins is coasting now to a win, and he has slipped on the water in that corner. Well, given the extraordinary spirit, power, energy, everything of his brother, Ivan Morales has been disappointing here, and this man, Lee Haskins, is on the way to retaining his title. Just a round to go. Can Morales find something extraordinary. Stand up. A little bit of tape there on the Haskins glove to make sure everything's okay ahead of this final round. So, final round. The crowd in Cardiff getting behind Lee Haskins now. Desperate for him to keep that IBF bantamweight title, which he surely will.
It's not over till it's over, so he's going to get through these 3 minutes.
Morales himself slipped on the canvas there.
May see a desperate attempt now from Morales to come forward, but that's actually suiting Haskins there, brought him onto a nice left hand.
Yeah, there's been a little bit of success for Morales. There was again there, but not enough.
Never really sustained it, Dave, has he? He had a glimpse here and there of what he should be doing. Then he just goes back on the outside again. Slows everything down.
Morales is trying to come forward and trying to find Haskins, but he can't. Well, there were plenty who thought Haskins might finish it early, plenty who felt Morales might outwork him and put him under pressure late, but not many saw Haskins just coasting to a win. Good fitness from him, good tactically, and he's dealt with what's in front of him, unless Morales can find a miracle shot.
I think you've got to give Haskins all the credit in the world for slowing things down and you're right, taking him into the 12th round. Who would have thought that? People thought that Haskins should have tried to get it over quickly the first five or six rounds. If he went over that, then there were question marks whether Morales was going to outwork him, but he's controlled the pace very well. It suited him, and it suited his style for the 12 rounds, his work rate.
Final 30 seconds now. Haskins kicked one of the camera men there and had time to reach out and apologise. Making Morales miss there. Great head movement from Haskins and then matches him with the shot. Little moment there when Haskins came alive right at the end of the fight. He came here as world champion, and barring something ridiculous, he's going to leave as world champion, having won it in the ring.
Look at the body language of both boxers. Haskins knows he's won it. Morales just walked back to his corner, head down, shaking his head. Couldn't figure his opponent out. And you're right, David, never really caught fire, did it, this contest. But at the same time, it was really important, so important, crucial that he got the win to set up bigger contests down the road, and he's done that. And he's won a world title in the ring. That's the main thing. He is now a recognised world champion by everyone.
Yeah, they're thrilled with it. Looks like it's going to be that rematch against Stewie Hall. And Ivan Morales, all the body language tells you everything you need to know. That was not him at his best. He could never work Haskins out. Lee Haskins, as Richie was saying earlier, said with a smile on his face in the week, they all say the same thing. We've watched him box and we can work him out. And so few do. And Ivan Morales joins a pretty long list.
I think the most disappointing thing with Morales' performance, Dave, he's never really changed anything about it, did he? There were glimpses that he was going to step on the gas a little bit and put him under more pressure, but just stayed on the outside, didn't really use his height and reach to to full advantage. And he was mesmerised, I think, by Haskins slowing things down. And you had a champion there dictating things, basically. And it wasn't the best contest to watch, no, it wasn't. But, you know, it's horses for courses, and he's got the job done. And that's all that matters to him. There's his young family in the ring, that's nice.
They're all that matters. And he wants to keep operating at this world level, Lee Haskins. It's one thing winning it, he's got to keep it. He believes he belongs here, and he's going to have fun while he is here. Let's get the official verdict now. Surely a Haskins win.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Howard Foster will bring together the boxers. Referee Phil Edwards has asked that I ask you to join him congratulating both boxers in the ring. So ladies and gentlemen, we go to our judges for totals. Judge Alan Davis, 119.108. And both judges, Howard Foster and Alex Levin, 118.110 in favour of the winner. And still, the IBF
Haskins is champion of the world, and this time it's in the ring. Great moment for him. He moves on surely now to a domestic world title fight against Stewie Hall. Wins on points 119-108 and 218-110. We'll hear from the man who is still the champion.
That must feel for you. I've won it in the ring. This really feels real now.
It was absolutely amazing. Yeah, you know, the crowd, everything was. It was my dream come true tonight, and it was amazing.
Dare I say, almost, you needed to win it in the ring to feel really legitimate about it.
Yeah, of course. You know, I felt legitimate when I beat Wasser. You know, he was a top fighter, one of the best. I beat him comfortably, and you know, I've just beat this guy comfortably as well. And I'm flying at the moment. Can I just quickly say, I want to say a massive, massive thanks to a man that this would never have happened if it wouldn't have happened for Barry McGuigan and my manager, Chris Sanniger.
Thank you very much.
Well, that's nice of you to show at a moment like this exactly what it means. Carl, what were your thoughts on Lee's performance?
I thought he was brilliant. He looked very in control the whole way through it. I think Morales was a good fighter, but Lee just tamed him. Good fighter, could punch hard. It looked like he punched quite hard, but Lee was on form tonight and looked brilliant.
Completely in control, Barry. Was.
Yeah, I did mention at the beginning, I thought his angles were going to give the guy problems. He's absolutely brilliant. He's one of the most underestimated fighters in the country. He hasn't been given the recognition that he has, and we hope now with Channel 5 that we'll give him the chance to fight again. Stuart Hall is his mandatory. He's already beaten him. He's already beaten McDonald. Yep. This kid is a tremendous fighter, and he needs these opportunities.
It's inevitable we're looking ahead already, so a rematch with Stuart Hall is mandatory. Are you looking forward to that?
All I was thinking during the training for this fight, I didn't want to look past it, but what I was thinking during the fight, in the training, Stuart Hall, he's the one I want. You know, I'm literally going to punch his face in, you know. gives me some BS online and all stuff like that, talking, you know, he's just talking a wet dream. But listen, I beat him easy before. I'm going to beat him even easier again, even easier than that fight just
had. He was giving you some jit, but quite recently in print, wasn't he?
I don't know what his problem is. I don't know if it's because I got more hair than him, or he's got more hair on his eyebrows than he has his head, you know. But listen, seriously, I'm gonna give him less. He wants the lesson again. I'm gonna give it to him again.
Domestic fight for a world title. Cut doesn't without, get better than that, Barry.
Doesn't get better than that. I mean, it's fantastic. I mean, Carl understands. He's just beaten Scott Quigg comprehensively, and this guy is a really talented kid. He's 32 years old. Not a mark on him. Fresh as a daisy. These are big fights. He can get the Jimmy McDonald fight as well. We really want them on Channel 5. So let's have it.
So is that the route in a perfect world? Stewie Hall and then Jamie McDonald in a perfect world?
Well, Chris has got something to say about it too, but ideally, he's a mandatory. He's got to do it within 90 days. So, you know, let's have it.
Let's have a quick word with Chris Sanniger. I'll just sit behind you. I was asking you this not too long ago, of course, with Andrew Selby, but Stewie Hall is the mandatory challenger next.
Yes, and, you know, it'd be great to get it on. Like Lee said, he gave him a boxing lesson last time, and this time he'd like to knock him out.
You know, Carl, exactly as we were saying, when you have a domestic fight, which is a world fight, of course, which you had with Scott Quigg, that really does take it to another level.
The fans really get behind you. These are the fights that you want. You know, it's all well and good beating people like Morales, who's a very good fighter, but There's something a little bit special about domestic world title fights, and Lee's already beaten Stuart Hall. I think Stuart Hall is a confident fighter. I think he'll be looking for redemption. It's up to Lee to prove that he's a better fighter, that the first one wasn't a fluke, that he can do it again. But I think it has the makings of a great fight, and he's got so much. He's got everything, and but again, that's the fight everyone wants to see.
And this gives you exposure now, doesn't it, having won it in this manner, rather than because you're staring at somebody and you're looking at their weight on the scales thinking, what's going on here? I'm going to win this without getting into the ring.
Yeah, that's right. You know, it's very hard. And, you know, Channel 5 has given me so many chances, you know, and, you know, I'm doing well on all of them. It must be my lucky number, I don't know. But everything's going well. And like I said, let's get Hall down here and give him a boxing lesson again.
Final word from you, Barry.
Well, I thought it was an immaculate performance. Perfect. Punch perfect the whole way through. He's really hitting his form now at the age of 32, which is quite remarkable for a bantamweight. So the Stewie Hall fight is there for him. Let's hope he can win the purse bids and let's give him a chance.
And you said just finally, what the five things you like about boxing, you said the day after when I've won. So yeah, you wake up tomorrow morning world champion.
I'm going to feel on top of the world, even in a minute in the changing room, just giving everybody a cuddle, you know, just... It's all over now. I can just go back to my three kids and just...
...a little bit. Should have been doing this a lot earlier, Dave. I'm surprised his corner. Having said, step in. Double that jab up. Get to your man. Commit a little bit more. Put him under a little bit more pressure.
That right jab to the body there from Ivan Morales, but he hasn't done enough. If the saying goes, the challenger has to come and rip the title from the champion. He's come nowhere near that. He's expecting all energy, a little bit wild, but we haven't seen that at all.
He hasn't sustained any pressure, has he, in any attacks? The odd single shot's gone in, long straight left hand, yes. Yeah, look there, nice right hook, but he just tends to just take a step back rather than go forward and put pressure on.
Well, he looked such a confident man in the dressing room. Carl Frampton spoke about it, relaxed, but he hasn't looked confident in the ring, Ivan Morales.
I watched the contest when he fought Jimenez and lost on a split decision there, a majority decision, and he concedes his height and reach a lot. Well, he did in that contest. I thought that would suit Haskins. He stood a little bit taller here, but the pace was a lot more in the Jimenez fight. It was a lot faster. Maybe we have to give Haskins credit for slowing things down, because the pace has suited Haskins down to the ground, and Morales and his corner, they haven't really sussed that out. And at one point, I thought he was going to step on the gas and really go for Haskins and put him under a little bit more, but it's back to the same as.
Haskins with a huge swing there. One landed after the bell from Morales. Haskins dominant. Surely on the way to retaining his title, but still plenty of time to go. We can hear now from Carl Frampton to get his views with Mark Pugac.
Thanks, Dave. Yes, Carl, what do you think? He's comfortably ahead, isn't he, Lee?
I think he is comfortably ahead. I think out of push, I would give Morales one round. Maybe even just give it level, but Lee's doing well here. Morales is starting that round. There were signs of him becoming a little bit more ragged. I think Lee can take advantage of that, but he's looking good and comfortably in lead.
So as far as he's concerned, just carry on like this for the next few rounds and he should be home and dry.
Continue to do what he's doing. I think that if he continues to do that, the more ragged that Morales becomes, I think he could catch him and possibly stop him late.
Carl, thank you. I'll speak to you later.
Thanks very much indeed, Mark. Ivan Morales said beforehand, I want the name of our family to be immortal. Three brothers to be world champions. Well, he needs to produce something very, very special to make that happen. He needs a stoppage now, Richie.
I think so. I think the corner have told him that. I think the corner have said, the way he's come out in this round, it's all or nothing now. You just got to go for it. You're well behind. Put him under a little bit. And that's what he's doing. There's more action in the first 30 seconds of this round. There has been in a lot of the rounds for Morales, so he's coming forward, taking the odd risk, yes, because Haskins likes boxers to come forward. But he's losing, so he's got to do something different here. Hey, Morales, he's got to go for it.
Three rounds to go after this. Can Morales find that special something that he needs now? Or will it be Haskins' night in Cardiff on his way to that all-British world title fight against Stewie Hall? Looking that way, but Morales, given that little bit of power he has, must still have an outside chance. Looking slimmer by the second, though.
Yeah, most definitely, Dave. You just got to, you know, Haskins has got to keep concentrating. We're four rounds away from winning this contest. But look at Morales now. I think he senses it now. He's behind, going forward. It's a better round for Morales. So it's all about concentration now. Haskins should be fit enough. But at this level, you take your eye off the ball, and it could all be over one shot.
It's the level at which Lee Haskins has always wanted to operate, and finally is operating. Right. Bill Edwards having a word with them. Desperately trying to make this a more watchable spectacle. Haskins, though, doing enough.
There again. Classic case of one boxer's feet far too slow. Morales coming forward. Haskins can see these attacks coming. Just adjusts his feet. And being a counter puncher the way he is, it's perfect for him at the moment.
Let's try and take a listen now to Chris Saniger again in that Lee right. Haskins corner.
Just need to be busy with that jab now, you know what I mean? All right?
Yeah. You've got to go to your left a little more, okay?
Well, they look like they're
looking awesome, buddy. Awesome. Awesome.
In control.
Keep moving.
Keep having right, the jab. You know, Lee Haskins will want to keep entertain. There's Richie's scorecard, just that one shared round, the eighth, but Haskins in total command.
Right, yeah.
But he'll want to entertain, but he also wants to hold on to his world title. It's the tightrope that he's walking.
You've got to hold on to the title at all costs, especially at his age.
Three rounds to go. Haskins coming out and throwing just about his best combination of the fight there. Morales looking for that left hand all the time.
Nice fast start for Haskins in this round. I think that spurred Morales on as well, remember? Barry McGuigan described his family as Mexican royalty in terms of boxing. Remember the boxing royalty, Mexican boxing royalty, that's what Bantamweight said. Super shot from Haskins.
A lovely clean shot from Haskins as Morales took a risk, and Morales felt that and he walked on to another one. Throws punches from such unusual angles, Haskins.
Well, that was a great shot because he seemed to change direction and threw the shot. Very good indeed. Moving to his left and then just very quickly moves to his right and throws that left hand, brings his opponent onto it.
And they look worried in that Morales corner. A little glance over to them. I wonder if their man has the answers here.
This is where it could go either way, though, now, Dave. They're both trying to land big shots. And with Lee Haskins with those hands so low, he's got to watch what he's doing.
He trusts his instincts, he always has done, trusts his reactions. Right to the body from Haskins, and they can be punishing shots late on in a fight. Using his feet well now, Haskins really warming to the task. Looks like he's got plenty in the tank as well.
Yeah, clever movements from Haskins. Just going to watch that low lead hand of his as Morales is coming forward. He's looking to land that left hand, you see. And Haskins cleverly just trying him up on the inside and gets back to range.
It has never really caught fire.
No, it's another classic, but the important thing is for Lee Haskins is to win, get over the line, and bigger fights are to follow. But this one's not over yet.
I wonder if Haskins can...
Shots coming from Haskins. It's a little bit better. And the pace is suiting him. But again, there are signs that Morales is starting to think a little bit more of getting up close, moving those feet into position. It's not a bad left hand there for Morales.
Yeah, just little encouraging moments for Morales, who must be behind on all three scorecards. It's hard to make a case for him winning a round so far. But as the younger man by 8 years, he'll always have felt that if he could take this late, he would give himself a chance.
Just heard the Haskins corner saying, get your feet moving. They know when he's moving those feet, it's causing more problems, he's more elusive for Morales. They can't just tag him and nail him down.
Nice. All right, use your experience, but mobile.
Well, there's
mobile.
Richie's scorecard so far. You've got Lee Haskins winning every round.
I think he's taken every round, yeah. Some of the rounds have been a little bit closer, but he's done enough to win them for me.
So Lee Haskins in the blue shorts here, the man from Bristol, defending his IBF bantamweight title against Ivan Morales, most famous thus far for being the younger brother of the great Erik, wanting to become respected and famous in his own right. Every time Haskins gets close, Morales is holding. Haskins yet really to land a solid, spiteful shot.
Slight change in tactics here from Morales. He's opting to go on the back foot, maybe to draw Haskins in a little bit. It's been Haskins on the back foot for most of this contest up to now. That style certainly suits him. Good head movement there, needed to come back with something. But Morales, his corner may have said, right, you've got to bring him on to you. They know he's behind.
You can see that's frustrating Haskins already a couple of times. He's gestured for Morales to say, come on. Doesn't like Morales sitting back. Left there was a stiff shot from Morales. Haskins landed as well as he came in.
Yeah, both landing shots there. Worrying sign there for Haskins. He got caught just on the way out, but a good reply again from Haskins, putting his man under pressure.
And that was better from Haskins. Can he sustain the pressure, though? Can he take Morales somewhere he doesn't want to go? Mandatory for this title is Stewie Hall, a man who Haskins has already beaten, trying to set up an all-British world title fight. Good work there from Haskins as we approach the final minute of this sixth round, and Morales is starting to take a risk or two.
I think he knows he's behind Dave, so yeah, he's taking a risk coming forward occasionally. Terrible miss there from Haskins, but again, he slowed the pace down. He's controlling the pace for me. Morales is not doing enough to win these rounds. There's a lovely right up to the body there from Haskins. That was a terrific shot.
Haskins again missed with a big left hook. Looking for that finishing punch that hasn't been there.
Just skimmed off the target in that left hand, but again, Haskins round.
There is the Iván Morales corner, led by Carlos Enrique Duanche, Diego Morales and Alberto Lopez, so one big brother in there. Trying to encourage him. A little change of tactics in the previous round. Will Morales stay on the back foot? And look to catch Haskins as he comes in.
He had a bit of success with it. He caught Haskins as Haskins was moving away a couple of times. So he's obviously trying to draw Lee Haskins in, but I just don't think he's doing enough to win these rounds for me, Morales. He's on away soil, remember. He's going to be taking these rounds. He's not doing it. He's not doing enough work. He's waiting far too long. And his feet are just a little bit too slow, Dave. He's going to sustain a little bit more pressure and put Haskins, for me, under a bit more pressure. I think Haskins has controlled the pace really well. And it's not a blistering pace, but it's a pace that is suiting him.
Well, given that beforehand, many felt the danger for Haskins was that Iván Morales might outwork him, given that Haskins has just thrown the best punch of the fight and caught Morales. He hasn't applied any kind of game plan here. He certainly hasn't outworked Haskins, and he felt that shot. Tries to respond with a left hand of his own.
Yeah, Haskins just allowed him 15, 20 seconds to recover from that left hand. That was the best left hand that he'd thrown, Lee Haskins. It was a good shot, but Morales, you could tell, he felt it the way he went back. Nothing came back for him for a good 15, 20 seconds. Then he comes back with his own straight left. And boxers at this level, after 10 or 15 seconds from a shot like that, they're recovered, they're that fit. But it was a good shot from Lee Haskins.
One accusation about Haskins over the years was always that he was guilty sometimes of admiring his work, and I think that's what he did there. He caught him with a great shot, didn't follow it up.
Haskins himself taking risks, though, Dave, coming forward there with very low hands. Both missed the target there, but both really went for it.
Neither have been able really to judge the distance between the other just yet. Both miss, both have felt like they've thrown shots from the wrong kind of range.
This could come down, Dave, to some lapse in concentration. I think Haskins is well ahead here. The longer this contest goes on, his concentration levels start to dip a little bit, and that's when you can walk onto a big shot. Got to keep alert. He's doing well up to now. There's still five or six rounds away from the end.
Five to go after this. So there's Chris Sanniger in there with Nigel Christian and Dave Moxon. You can have a listen to him.
Yeah. Well, a little squirt down there as well. Well, open your mouth.
Come to you when you're ready.
Okay.
Oh, easy.
Let's take a look at some of the work from that round.
Yeah, good shot there from Morales, but there's that left hand. It actually hit the glove, didn't it? looked from our position at the landing, but it didn't. Then they went for it. This was where they both stepped in. But Haskins just allowed Morales just to step off and recover.
So Lee Haskins surely well ahead. This round eight, the first defence of his IBF bantamweight title, and a chance to have the feeling of being a world champion in the ring. That was a tangle of legs, by the way.
Lovely shot there from Haskins, throwing that jab from the hip. Very hard to detect when the jab thrown from there. Not recommended for everyone to do it. Obviously, the hands are very low, but occasionally just catches your opponent as it did there. Good punch.
And look at his corner there from Morales. Little flurries of action here.
Morales starting to step on the gas.
Turn on the style now as we approach the final couple of rounds. Well, two rounds to go. Haskins started the round with that great bit of work, and Morales certainly felt those shots, and he looks frustrated in that corner.
Yeah, it was a fast start to the round from Lee Haskins. Lovely 1-2 combination. Fast out of the blocks there. Lovely left hand, that's the best shot of the round for Haskins. Brought his opponent onto it as he led to his right. And another round for him.
Absolutely. Final bit of advice, but it could be an awkward hurdle, but looks like he's getting over it okay. Yeah, Haskins just looking at the bit of water that was down in that corner, asking for it to be mopped. He looked bothered by it. The minute he came out, and he has slipped a couple of times. Finally, we can get back underway. Well-timed shot again there from Haskins.
He's boxing well again on the back foot, Lee Haskins. Starting to bring his opponent again onto that left hand. Morales knows he's behind. Yeah, the referee there, I think he's had enough of Haskins holding on the inside. So he's just got to be careful these next 6 minutes or so. He doesn't want as a warning. I think he's well ahead though, Dave. He really is. But he's clearly probably feeling a little bit and getting a little bit more tired. That's why he's holding on the inside, just to get a little bit of a breather.
Yeah, it doesn't feel like a point deduction would be the end of the world, but he'd still rather not have that reputation. Remember, this was someone who used to be criticised for being in dull fights. He's lost that reputation, but he doesn't want it back. Held again there, you know. Will Edwards had another look at it. To go in the penultimate round. And the uppercut there from Haskins. Now Morales is coming forward, is trying to hunt Lee Haskins down, but he's hard to fight.
Well, that's part of the game plan you see from Haskins there. The movement is very good indeed, and he's just inviting his opponent to come forward, because then he comes back with very fast counters. You've got to be fit to do this type of work, but it's good at the moment from Haskins. That's all he's doing there, on the outside, keeping that movement going. inviting his opponent to come forward to try and get desperate and bring him onto a shot.
Oh, can he finish with a powerful flourish here?
There are big fights down the road, aren't there? From a British perspective, Shuey Hall is the mandatory for Haskins if he gets through this. There's Jamie McDonnell also, WBA champ. So exciting times ahead for Lee Haskins if he can win this contest.
Morales for a moment thought he had him in the corner, but Haskins used his good footwork to get out of there. Just feels like Haskins is coasting now to a win, and he has slipped on the water in that corner. Well, given the extraordinary spirit, power, energy, everything of his brother, Ivan Morales has been disappointing here, and this man, Lee Haskins, is on the way to retaining his title. Just a round to go. Can Morales find something extraordinary? A bit of tape there on the Haskins glove to make sure everything's okay ahead of this final round. So, final round. The crowd in Cardiff getting behind Lee Haskins now. Desperate for him to keep that IBF bantamweight title, which he surely will.
It's not over till it's over, so he's going to get through this 3 minutes.
Morales himself slipped on the canvas there.
May see a desperate attempt now from Morales to come forward, but that's actually suiting Haskins there, brought him onto a nice left hand.
Yeah, there's been a little bit of success for Morales. There was again there, but not enough.
Never really sustained it, Dave, has he? He's had the odd glimpse here and there of what he should be doing. Then he just goes back on the outside again. Slows everything down.
Morales is trying to come forward and trying to find Haskins, but he can't. Well, there were plenty who thought Haskins might finish it early, plenty who felt Morales might outwork him and put him under pressure late. But not many saw Haskins just coasting to a win. Good fitness from him, good tactically, and he's dealt with what's in front of him. Unless Morales can find a miracle shot.
I think you've got to give Haskins all the credit in the world for slowing things down. And you're right, taking him into the 12th round, who would have thought that? People thought that Haskins should have tried to get it over quickly the first five or six rounds. If he went over that, then there were question marks whether Morales was going to outwork him, but he's controlled the pace very well. It suited him, and it suited his style for the 12 rounds, his work rate.
Final 30 seconds now. Haskins kicked one of the camera men there and had time to reach out and apologise. Making Morales miss there. Great head movement from Haskins, and then catches him with the shot. little moment there when Haskins came alive right at the end of the fight. He came here as world champion, and barring something ridiculous, he's going to leave as world champion, having won it in the ring.
Look at the body language of both boxers. Haskins knows he's won it. Morales just walked back to his corner, head down, shaking his head. Couldn't figure his opponent out. And you're right, David, never really caught fire, did it, this contest. But at the same time, it was really important, so important, crucial, and he got the win to set up bigger contests down the road, and he's done that. And he's won the world title in the ring. That's the main thing. He is now a recognised world champion by everyone.
Yeah, they're thrilled with it. Looks like it's going to be that rematch against Stewie Hall. And Ivan Morales, all the body language tells you everything you need to know. That was not him at his best. He could never work Haskins out. Lee Haskins, as Richie was saying earlier, said with a smile on his face in the week, they all say the same thing. Certainly a feeling around boxing, though, that when Lee Haskins was crowned world champion, one of the nice guys had done it. Really popular. A little warning there from Phil Edwards, holding and hitting there. Nothing serious, but just a word in his ear.
Close to this round, Dave, and I still think that Haskins has done enough just to nick the round. Fairly good start again from Haskins.
There's the Ivan Morales corner. Diego Morales is in there. There's that shot, Richie.
Yeah, that was a nice shot from Morales. Good clean shot that he landed there. I just thought that Haskins did enough to win the round. I got him two rounds up, but it was a closer round.
Yeah, Erik Morales not here. Diego Morales, who did also briefly hold a world title, is in the corner with Carlos Duarte and Alberto Lopez. Can they encourage their man and school him sufficiently to cause the upset here and rip away Lee Haskins' world title that he's waited so long for?
What's important here, Dave, is for Haskins, when Morales is coming forward, he's got to adjust his feet and go backwards and try and bring him onto a counter, because if he doesn't, if he holds his feet, he's got such a low lead hand, and he's just going to walk onto another left hand for Morales. So he's got to adjust his feet, step back, bring him onto the shot as Morales comes forward. Very important. That's better. There you go.
Morales with those hands held high keeps coming forward, but Haskins caught him again there. Danger of being a little bit messy and scrappy. Haskins just biding his time and trying to pick his shots here. The right hand, Morales moved backwards there.
I think Morales is realizing he's got to get closer to Haskins. He's starting to come forward a lot more now on that front foot than he was in the opening couple of rounds. And if he comes forward with slow feet, that will suit Haskins. Haskins can bring him onto the shot as long as he adjusts, like I said.
And in this third round, Morales has really started to unload, significantly so. Interesting clash of styles, this often is with Lee Haskins, and that's good work from him.
It's important that Morales keeps that guard high as he's coming forward. He's got a fairly slow jab, and that's allowing Haskins to come back with that left hand counter. His feet are too slow at this stage. Morales, he's got to quicken things up if he's going to get to Lee Haskins, and may have to double up the attack rather than just that single attack. I think Haskins there just signaled to the referee of a clash of heads there.
Morales can look a little square as well. Those feet are a bit slow, and in that fight against Edgar Jimenez, you saw him almost walking onto shots. So far, so good, but nothing definitive yet for Lee Haskins.
Beautiful. Come on.
So there's the Lee Haskins corner. Well. Hearing the words of Chris Saniger.
That will stick it in.
Known Lee since he was 14 years of age. So proud, so happy when Haskins beat Iwasa, and then after that interim title was crowned world champion. But he wants now to keep it going. Haskins in the blue shorts against Ivan Morales, the Mexican, the younger brother of the great, and I mean great, Erik Morales.
Well, Erik was the first Mexican to win four different weights, four world titles at different weights, wasn't he? What a legend.
Morales then just looking at Phil Edwards and suggesting Haskins was using the elbow.
I think Haskins is dealing with the single attacks with no real problems. That was a nice shot, that was a nice move there from Haskins. Just leads with the hook, but then comes back with that left hand, that was good. I think Morales has got to double up the attacks, or maybe double up the jab. Put a little bit more sustained pressure on Haskins. He's going to get to him. He's got to go again. That's when he's got to go. See how he stopped after that single attack. That just allows that Haskins just to step back and assess the situation, regroup. So the pace is suiting him.
Haskins landed there, but so too did Morales with a left hook.
Morales is learning as he's going along. He's got to get closer. Got to quicken those feet up. Bit of swelling below the right eye of Morales now. Testament of that, those left hands that Haskins has been landing.
A little slow again with that southpaw jab, Morales. Left uppercut from Haskins as again, Morales just can't get his shots away. Bristolian voices in this Cardiff crowd trying to encourage their man. Long left there from Morales. Just caught Haskins. Single shot there from Morales.
I don't know what Haskins was doing there. He just showboating a little bit there and got caught. Hands very, very low. Playing with fire there. Moving that head so close.
When you move the best as well. Bit by bit.
Well, he just gets caught with a shot here, doesn't he? Lee Haskins. Oh, this is actually stuff from earlier on in the round. Just moving his head in and out, then gets caught there on the way out with that shot. Good shot from Morales, but he didn't do enough to win the round for me.
Well, Lee Haskins has completed 12 rounds on six occasions. Morales never. That might come into play here. Although Haskins will hope not. He will hope to catch Morales and get this done quicker than that.
See, that's the problem there. So Morales now just quickening those feet up. Once he does that and then throws that left hand, he's going to catch Haskins. Haskins, the way he's moving, he's got to keep that right hand a little bit higher. That's a little bit better. You've got to get that guard up, else you're going to walk onto those left hands. Morales is sussing it out now. He's thinking, I've got to get closer to him. I've got to quicken the feet up. That's what he's trying to do now, Morales.
The opportunity missing badly there with it, left hook.
Yeah, and Dave, the opportunity may come for Haskins now to land a solid shot as Morales is getting more confident to come over that front foot.
Yeah, Morales growing in confidence, but with that confidence comes danger. Fight starting to warm up though in this fifth round. Little warning here from Phil Edwards just to encourage them not to hold, not to turn, not to spin, to make it a spectacle. Haskins unloaded there with that left, but Morales blocked it fairly comfortably.
Morales has kept a fairly high guard throughout, hasn't he? Blocked a lot of the shots. I think it's been a good start these first few rounds for Haskins, but he's just showing signs, Dave, of slowing down a little bit. Maybe just taking his foot off the gas slightly. A lot of single shot.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen in attendance here at ringside, and at this time a very warm welcome to you, the viewers, joining us at home. We're live on Channel 5 from the Ice Arena in Cardiff. Blaine McGuigan for Cyclone Promotions in association with Golden Boy Promotions and Sanagar Events, sponsored by Maxi Nutrition, Ladbrokes and Volterol for the joy of movement, are very proud to bring you 12 rounds of boxing for the IBF Bantamweight Championship of the World. All our officials at ringside, appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control and the International Boxing Federation. Joining me in the ring from the board, the chairman, John Rees QC, from the IBF, our supervisor, from New Jersey, USA, Mr. Eddie Cotton. Our three scoring judges, from Toronto, Canada, Mr. Alan Davis, from Doncaster, England, Mr. Howard Foster, from Orlando, Florida, USA, Mr. Alex Levin. On the bell, our timekeeper is Dave Waters. And when the bell rings, referee in charge, from Preston, England, Mr. Phil Edwards. And so, ladies and gentlemen in attendance here at ringside, and for those watching live on Channel 5, the officials are ready. The boxers are ready. Are you ready for the main event? Introducing the challenger. He's boxing out of the red corner. He's winning black with silver trim. At the weigh-in, he's scaled 8 stone, 5 pounds, 117 pounds. From 30 contests, 29 wins. 17 wins inside the distance, only one defeat. The reigning WBC International Silver Champion. Tonight, he is the challenger. Los Caballeros de Tijuana, Mexico, Ivan Morales. And across the ring stands the champion. Boxing out of the blue corner, winning blue with silver trim. On the scales, 8 stone, 5 pounds, 3 ounces, 117 and 1 quarter pounds. From 35 contests, 32 wins, 14 wins inside the distance, only 3 defeats. He is the former English champion, 2-weight British champion, 2-weight Commonwealth champion, former European champion. Tonight, making the first defense of his world crown, the reigning IBF Bantamweight Champion of the World, from Bristol, Avon, England, Lee Playboy Haskins.
Keep your punches on the target area, watch your head in close, and remember, defend yourselves at all times. Good luck.
God bless you both.
Well, having lost to Edgar Jimenez, just outworked against him, he's come back with a win, but this is a step up for Ivan Morales and for Lee Haskins. It is a chance to prove that he deserves to be world champion. Defends his title here tonight, but wants in his mind to win it in the ring. And one thing is for sure, Ivan Morales will never have fought anybody with the style of Lee Haskins, because there is no one with a style like Lee Haskins.
I read a great quote from Haskins before this contest, and he was saying that his opponents often say that they've worked him out and they know what they're going to do against him, and he says that's impossible, he said, because he doesn't know what he's going to do when he gets in there. He's a boxer that just reacts, boxes on instinct, throws punches from all different angles, very elusive, very difficult to get to, and he punches very hard, Dave.
When he's had problems, and he has had problems, it's when his unorthodoxy becomes predictable. Saw that against Stefan Jamwa, found out as well by Shafir Munyai and Ian Napper as well, but he is on quite a streak, Haskins, and he started powerfully here. Morales trying to win the battle of the jabs there. You never know what Haskins is going to lead with.
In his last contest against the Japanese boxer, Nosoki Iwasa, he was another tall, perfect preparation for this one, to be honest, because he was a tall southpaw also. And he sorted him out. He started very quickly, did Lee Haskins. But Morales here, he's just waiting, isn't he, a little bit. I think the pace is probably suiting Haskins at this stage. He prefers that leisurely pace, sees the opponents coming, and then he responds with those fast counters. So it's going okay for the moment anyway for Lee Haskins.
Break! A little bit scrappy there. When he fought Edgar Jimenez, who goes by the nickname of Power, which gives you the idea of what kind of fighter he is, real bull of a man. Morales tried to box it on the back foot, and Jimenez got to him, but he started with similar tactics here. A little chopping right there from Haskins. It was a good sneaky shot.
He's got to vary his power a little bit, Haskins. I don't want him putting everything into every shot. It's going to take it out of him a little bit. Remember, he's in a 12-round contest here, Morales. Mexican, they're all tough from over there. And keeping that guard nice and high. So a lot of these shots are hitting the gloves. He's looking for a clean shot here. If it lands, then, yeah, it may have an effect. But at the moment, then, Haskins is not hitting the target as such. It was a good body shot. Then.
Don't let him mislead you.
Well, Lee Haskins surely took that opening round.
A head and body. Head and body.
But Ivan Morales, as Richie's mentioned, will stick around unless he's encouraged to do otherwise. And that would be the worry, I think, for those who feel Haskins potentially could be beaten. It's that he'd be outlasted by this fella. Just a feeling that Haskins can work too hard in the early part of fights, and that he was blowing a bit against Iwasa, and he took him out with that wonderful shot, the shot of a lifetime. But Haskins looks relaxed, and he started well here. A couple of good shots as well, Richie.
He started very positively, won that first round. And he's putting some good work together here, but it is a 12-round contest, like we've said. So he's got to hit the target more cleanly for me, as Haskins. But he's in control at the moment. But like you said, Dave, if it does go over 7 or 8 rounds, those later, in the later stages, those championship rounds, gets caught there with a nice shot. Got to keep those hands up a little bit higher as his opponent's coming towards him.
Yeah, he walked on to a left hand there that he should have seen coming a mile away. Little moment of success for Ivan Morales. Haskins, though, on the front foot.
trying to take control of this fight. Right to the body from Haskins. He's missing a lot, though, Haskins, in these early stages.
The pace is actually suiting him, Dave. He slowed it down. And Morales is playing a waiting game, just the odd shot coming here and there. But Haskins, for me, like I said, he prefers this type of pace. Very good at slowing things down, he's Haskins. Because he likes to see the opponents coming and he can react with those counters. But when his opponent comes through there, he's just got to keep his hands a little bit higher as Haskins, getting caught with shots that he shouldn't really be.
Ivan Morales has won 29 of his 30 fights at the age of 24. 17 knockouts. He does have power if Haskins should walk in with his chin up in the air.